I'm Coyote Peterson, and I'm about to be bitten by the giant desert centipede. Here we go. Ah! Ah!
Just cut the cameras, cut the cameras. We gotta get the venom extracted. We gotta get some venom on my arm. Ah!
Cameras.
Yeah.
I'm rolling. Mario, here. Can you turn on the satellite phone just in case? I'm gonna get this venom extractor out.
Oh my gosh, guys, okay.
Tourniquet or no tourniquet?
I just wanna like it so it can. I think I'm gonna vomit. Okay. Oh my gosh. This is really bad. All right, Mario, you're gonna have to keep rolling on this. We got the GoPro going too.
Okay. That is spreading, right?
It is spreading. Now, we have never used a venom extractor before in an episode, guys. And it is so painful right now. And given the isolation of where I was bitten, when I was bitten by a gila monster, my thumb, we couldn't use a venom extractor. I'm gonna try to see if we can't suck some of that venom out of my forearm. The pain is so bad, I actually was almost in tears.
I'm gonna try to just get some of this off so I don't wanna put venom back in there.
Yeah. You can actually see the venom seeping out of the edge of my arm there. Look at the welt that is swelling. Now, if a centipede attacks a prey item.
Yeah, I can feel it's swelling bad. Okay, so there's two sites. There's site one, site two. Do you know which was first?
No, the one up front was the first one, and then it tucked its head back and it bit again, and actually you could see the black and blue mark there. I actually think that second spot injected more venom.
Yep.
So what you want to do is cut down on that.
I think I can get them all.
You may be able to get it all. Mario, you got a tight shot on that?
Okay.
Oh my gosh, that's only making it hurt worse. Oh my gosh, that's crazy. You can actually see the venom coming up through the holes where the fangs went. Can you see that? See if you can zoom in on that.
You gotta tell us if you feel like you gotta get out of here. We'll get you out of here.
Okay, I like the Gila monster bite. It comes in waves of pain. Right now, I'm at a downtrend in the pain. Now, waves of pain, guys. Okay, let's take this off.
You have to
unlock it.
I gotta put my camera down. Here we go. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. And I'm gonna take it down.
Okay, zoom in on that.
You definitely see the venom.
Oh my gosh, you could see the destruction in the arm right there. See how black and blue it's already turning? It is not as bad as the Gila monster. In the sense that the Gila monster sliced through my thumb and opened me up. But this absolutely eclipses any insect sting I have ever taken. It makes the bullet ant feel like a bee sting. It makes 30 bee stings to the face feel like putting on facial moisturizer. This is the most intense pain I have been in since the Gila monster. And in this moment, I am regretting being bitten by the giant desert centipede, guys. I do have this tourniquet on me, just lightly placed. You don't ever want to place the tourniquet down too tightly, because if you do, all you're doing is forcing your heart to beat faster and that venom to pump through your system quicker. Now, okay, I'm gonna wipe that back and we're gonna put the extractor on a second time.
Is it pens and needles pain?
Oh, no, it is searing pain. It is. Someone has taken a hot poker and shoved it into my forearm. My arm is in a state of paralysis right now. I cannot move my hand at all. My arm is swollen taut. Let's do a second extraction here.
Right.
Yeah. This actually hurts really bad just
One,
to do this. Ready?
Two, three.
That venom extractor just puts so much isolated pain right in that area. Ugh.
subsiding.
Now the venom from the giant desert centipede has a cocktail of potency, and that cocktail is called cytolysis. And right now what's happening is that venom is attacking my red blood cells and it is breaking them apart, and that is the pain that I am feeling right now. And trust me when I say it is unbelievably intense.
Wow.
Let's take off the venom extractor. All right, to do that, I gotta turn this and just unlock it, right?
Yep, yep.
Okay, ready?
Yep. No,
I don't
want
okay.
And, yep. Oh, yeah. You definitely see there's some residual venom coming out of there.
Okay. Let me get a shot of that with the GoPro. Man.
That is a lot of venom, actually.
Man, that is painful. It is easily as bad as I imagined. Oh my gosh. Oh.
Oh. Here, just take the tourniquet off your arm.
Yeah, go ahead, go ahead. Take that off. Take that off.
Ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
There's you guys.
Oh, man. First time we ever had to use the venom extractor.
The venom seems to have stopped at about the area where we had the tourniquet, which is good. I do believe that the venom extractor helped. Right now, all I want to do is simply get out of the hot desert sun and into an air-conditioned environment. All I can say is this, guys, if you ever come across one of these myriapods in the wild, simply admire it from a very safe distance. Do not try to catch it, do not try to handle it, because take my word for it, this pain is absolutely unbelievably intense. You do not want to be bitten by this animal. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave, stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure. If you ever have an encounter with a giant desert centipede in the wild, it's important to remember that these animals do their best to avoid humans, and interactions, let alone bites, are incredibly rare. As the hours passed by, my arm continued to throb. And the worst part of it all was that with every wave that rushed through my body, the pain was only intensifying. Several hours into the ordeal, I threw up the white flag and requested medical treatment for the bite. This was the first time that my mind and body were unable to endure the pain of a bite or a sting. It was truly that bad. All right, guys, well, it has been 30 hours since I was bitten by the giant desert centipede. Ah! Now that you've seen me go through this, hopefully you will truly take away a message that is you simply admire these things from a safe distance. I do not want to see pictures out there on Instagram or Facebook or Snapchat of anybody handling one of these myriapods. Guys, I'm tough, right? We know that. I've got a high pain tolerance, but this put me over the edge. It is more pain than I have ever been in. You can see on my face, I am exhausted right now. I have not slept in 36 hours, and it's a pain that I couldn't stop. That was the scariest part, is when the pain was taking over my arm all the way up into my shoulder. I couldn't stop it, and it was only becoming worse. In all of my time filming episodes for the Brave Wilderness Channel, I have not once gone to see a doctor after a bite or sting. The giant desert centipede put me in urgent care. That's how serious it is. In the end, was facing my fear of being bitten by this nightmare of a creature worth it? Well, at first, as I rolled around on the ground in agonizing pain, I would have told you no. However, now that the pain is long gone, and all that remains are the haunting memories, I would actually have to say that yes, it was worth it. Because together, we learned about the giant desert centipede, and most importantly, how bad the bite really is. If you are ever unfortunate enough to be bitten by one of these animals, seek medical treatment immediately. As for me, I'm sure that some of you still think I am absolutely crazy, but at least I can now proudly say that what was once my fear of centipedes has now evolved into a newfound fascination and respect for one of the planet's creepiest creatures. If you thought extracting venom from my arm looked painful, make sure to go back and watch where the chaos began as I was bitten by the giant desert centipede. Hey, Coyote Pack, I have some exciting news. I'm proud to announce that the crew and I will be back on tour in 2018 with Brave Wilderness Live, visiting cities all across North America. Our first shows are in Anaheim and San Diego, California. From there, we head to Phoenix, Arizona. Beyond that, we will be visiting San Francisco, California, Portland, Oregon, Seattle, Washington, and Boulder, Colorado, with many more shows to be announced in the coming months. Tickets can be purchased at the Brave Wilderness website, so make sure to reserve your seats today. And don't forget, subscribe so you can join me and the crew on this season of Breaking Trail. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave! Yeah!